Marjane Satrapi's Persepolis won international acclaim as an autobiographical tale, told first in the form of a graphic novel, and later turned into a film of a young girl's coming of age amid the 1979 Islamic Revolution in Iran. Now comes Chicken with Plums, another story based on her family's history from an earlier period. It was published in English translation in book form in 2006. The film version, co-directed by Satrapi and Vincent Parano, opens in theaters later this month. Here's a short excerpt.
Tu me le dis, hein, si je t'ennuie.
Non, non. On m'a cassé mon violon.
Nom de Dieu, mais qui t'a fait ça?
Quelle importance?
Tu es allé voir Mirza? Il a des instruments magnifiques.
T'es scroll. Il a essayé de me rouler, tous ses violons sont pourris. De toute façon, tel père, tel fils, c'est une famille de dégénérés. C'est foutu maintenant. J'arriverai plus jamais à jouer.
Mais attends. Le mois dernier, j'étais chez un vieil ami à Racht. Tu devineras jamais ce qu'il avait.
Regardez ce Stradivarius. Il a appartenu à Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart.
Demain, je pars pour Racht. Je vais aller chercher un violon.
Marjane Satrapi now lives in France. In addition to her book and film work, she contributes to magazines and newspapers around the world. She joins us now. Welcome to you.
Thank you very much.
If Persepolis was more explicitly about you and what was going on in your early life, what is this one, Chicken with Plums? What were you after here?
Well, actually, you know, it's not really a story of my family. It's many stories of different part of my family and many things that I have lived or the things that I have heard. It is like a couple of years ago, you know, I saw a photo of my grand uncle and he looked like a very handsome man. And he looked extremely melancholic, and I'm a very melancholic person once in a while. But that was a moment that I had all these questions about what was life and death and love and art, and I made a projection of
myself.
Just
the little things, right?
Just the little things, yeah. And I just wanted to make a story about all these things that I was very concerned with, so I used him, you know, and I made a projection of myself on this very handsome man.
Well, so the man is named Nasser Ali. He's a celebrated musician, as we see. He loses his violin, and then he sort of loses his purpose. And so it becomes a meditation on living and art, I guess. Huh?
Well, of course. I mean, he loses all the pleasures more than his violin. You know, the violin is actually just a purpose. It's just an excuse for a real story that is hidden behind this violin. Is when your heart is broken, you know, if you're honest, do we really survive a broken heart? I don't think so. And if we don't survive it and we start losing all the pleasures of life, then we die. But it's a movie that talks about all of that. Actually, it talks about death and it talks about depression and it talks about all of that just to celebrate life and the pleasure, and it has lots of humor. Because
yes, we should say it has a lot of humor, doesn't it? Yeah.
Yes, because if I present it like that, it, you know, this is the story of a depressed man, it sounds very boring. But I don't think it's boring at all.
Well, speaking of how you present it, I mean, we see in that little clip the magic side of it, right?
Yes.
The person who appears with the Stradivarius. So there's a kind of mixing of genres.
Absolutely, because, you know, the basis is that the characters, I'm extremely realistic about characters because we don't have any good and any bad. Everybody has his time that he's glorious and he has his time that he's really not nice. I'm being very realistic on who the characters are. But then, you know, about life, you know, in cinema there is no limit to our imagination than ourselves. And that is also a man that remembers all his memories. And when we remember our life, you know, the memories, they don't come in a chronological way. And, you know, some of them, they are very colorful and full of detail. Some of them, they are just, you know, like you just remember an action. So like that, you can just go. And cinema is word of imagination. And, you know, all this movie of the 50s that I saw, from Douglas Sirk to Pressburger and Powell to Lubitsch to Hitchcock, all these films
that really come through in this. Right?
Yes, that is all these films that I loved, you know, watching when I was a child, and I would watch them over and over. This is the reason why I loved cinema. That is the reason why I wanted to make film, and I also just wanted to celebrate all
of
that.
Well, these, of course, though, start in that graphic novel comic form.
Yes.
For which you first were known.
Yes.
Now, what is that especially good for, or what are the limits of that make you then want to turn it into a film?
Listen, to tell you the truth, I never wanted to become a movie maker. It was like I was a cinephile, and I go like 3-4 times per week to the cinema, and I like to watch films. But, you know, Persepolis, it was a friend of mine who wanted to become a producer, and I really thought it was the worst idea in the world to turn Persepolis to a film. Mm-hmm. Because, first of all, the adaptation, they are never good. If the author wants to make it, it's even worse. So I was like, no, no, no. But then, you know, it was this little Jiminy Cricket in me who was saying, you know, they're going to pay you that you will make a new experience. Are you crazy to say no? So it was really for making a new experience, being convinced that it was a very bad idea. Then Chicken with Plum is another story that I love, obviously, since I wrote it. I think it's a very good story. And I think that the story itself was very cinematographic, and I really wanted to make a melodrama. Mm-hmm. I wanted to make a real love story with a bad ending, because a love story that ends good is the life of everyone, you and I, for example. I always say to people, you know, if Romeo and Juliet, they got married, nobody would care about them, you know. Imagine Romeo and Juliet, 6 kids, yelling, Mama, Mama, Papa.
We don't want to hear that story.
No, absolutely.
Right?
That is our life. It's not interesting.
But go back to the way these start in the graphic novel form.
Yes.
Which is your art form first,
yes,
right?
Yes.
What is that good for, as opposed to either writing in traditional novel form or making an original film?
Well, listen, for me, who loves to draw and who loves to write, mm-hmm, and cannot choose between one or the other, mm-hmm, the comic is the best form. And also, I'm a little bit shy, you know, to talk, you know, like I was very sad, or, you know, to describe, you know, when I have, like, you know, when I'm too sentimental, I'm too shy to describe them, but I can make a drawing of myself and it's short. Mm-hmm. In words, it becomes too much for me. I cannot do it. And I think there are things with the drawings that we can do also, because, you know, drawing is the first language of human being, you know, before writing, before even talking, before words, mm-hmm, human being were drawing. So it is a form that fitted me very well, but it's a very solitarian work. Mm-hmm. And I am a only child who has been always solitarian. And I found suddenly the joy of collaborating with other people when I make movies. And I think it's lots of fun to make movies. And right now I feel like making movies. Maybe later on I will come back to my comic books again.
Persepolis opened a window for many people on a time and place, Iran,
yes,
right? This opens a very different sort of window.
Absolutely.
But the same place. And I wonder, you know, you're in our world, and here we are at a news program. We see Iran in the daily news all the time. We don't see that history, I guess, or culture that you lived and write about.
Absolutely. Unfortunately, you know, Iran is reduced, you know, to veil and beard and nuclear weapon. And nobody
veil and beard and nuclear weapon.
Yes. And nobody talks about our great poets and our great philosopher and our thousands of years of history and culture. And this is really sad because, you know, this country is not just this 30 past years. It's 4,000 years. And, you know, it was a very close relationship, for example, between United States and Iran. I mean, people, they say we didn't know it. And that was old people. They know it. They just forgotten it. And, you know, when I make a film like that, of course, you know, I don't think that with a film you can change the life or the world, et cetera, et cetera. But, you know, beyond, you know, the beautiful love story, if people, they can go and watch this film and to say, you know, in this country that we don't know anything about and we think is an abstract notion of axis of evil or whatever, mm-hmm, a man died because of a love of a woman. And I think that is just as much important as anything else, because if we talk about the news program, the difficulty, the problem when we did reduce people to or a country to a notion, then they become abstract. And from the second they stop being human beings, then we can go and bomb them and kill them. And this is not a problem. If we don't forget that you're human beings like us that might fall in love and even die of love, then it makes it a little bit more complicated.
All right. This film, the new film, is Chicken with Plums. Marjane Satrapi, nice to talk to you.
It was great talking to you, too.